Right now, we're keeping a very close eye up on Capitol Hill, where lawmakers say they are making progress on a new economic stimulus package is expected to include a new round of direct payments to individuals, something that our next guest has been pushing for very, very strongly. Senator Bernie Sanders of Vermont is joining us from Capitol Hill. Senator, thanks so much for joining us. And I know this is an issue that is close to your heart. You've been critical of the current coronavirus relief proposals, saying they simply don't go far enough to do what is really needed. But from your perspective on the latest information you're getting, what's missing?
Well, number one, the entire bill at $900 billion is much too low. It should be at least double that. So what's in this current bill is good, but it's not enough. Now, what I recognized a couple of weeks ago, that there were no direct payments going out to people in this country, many of whom are in desperate economic shape. As you well know, Wolf, we got a record-breaking level of hunger in America, higher than it's been for a very, very long time. You got millions of people who are facing eviction. They can't afford to pay their rent. They're going deeper into debt. And we're looking at people in the midst of the worst pandemic in 100 years who can't afford to go to the doctor because they don't have enough money. So what I have fought for, along with a Republican senator, Senator Holly of Missouri, is to make sure there are direct payments similar to what we did in the CARES Act in March. And that would be $1,200 for every working class person in America, people under 75,000, a couple under 150,000, and $500 for each of their children. So a family of four would get $3,400, which is not insignificant in this moment when so many people are hurting.
But just to be precise, that yet hasn't been accepted, what you want, right?
That is right. Where we're at right now, as I understand it, is we're between $600 and $700 for adults and $600 for children. So we are making progress, but I want us to go even further. Because I think when you ask people out on the street, what is the most important thing the government can do in this terrible, terrible moment? They will say, give us some help. We need some help right now to pay the bills. And that's what we're trying to do.
Researchers have found, Senator, that since June, it's hard to believe this is happening in our country, some 7.8 million Americans have fallen into poverty. Now, these are people who had jobs, were making a living, they were paying the rent, buying food, doing what they needed to do. But now they are in poverty right now. And it's hard to believe this is going on. And what's so frustrating to me and so many others, why is it taking so long to help these millions of Americans?
Well, you know, I don't want to become overly political here, but it is clear to me that we have a Republican majority here in the Senate who has refused to entertain and still refuses to entertain the kind of funding that is needed to provide nutrition, to help people who are being evicted, to make sure that people in this crisis, can you believe it, in the midst of this terrible pandemic, everyone's afraid of getting the virus, and you got 90 million people who are unable to go to the doctor when they get sick. So many of us had fought for adequate funding, and we've met very stiff resistance from Mitch McConnell and the Republican leadership. But, you know, what we got now is not enough, but it is something. And I'm just simply happy to say that as we enter the holiday season, when so many people are worried about how they're going to pay their bills, whether they're going to get evicted, whether they're going to feed their kids, at least, among other things, there'll be $600 per adult and $600 per child as well. So that's a start. I want to do better.
So obviously, even though you want more, you'll vote in favor of this compromise, whatever emerges. Is that right?
I want to read the bill. It's a long, long bill. But I'm feeling good that we have made some progress at least. You know, a week ago, as you know, nobody was talking about direct payments. We got something in the bill, and I want to thank my progressive friends in the House for their good work on this. We're making some progress.
Because, you know, as I often say, and I've said it to the Speaker, Nancy Pelosi, and others, when you're dealing with a crisis like this, you can't let the perfect be the enemy of the good, because so many millions of people out there are suffering. You might not get everything, Senator, but you're going to get a bunch that will make life better for these people, right?
Well, one of the other things that we're going to get is extended unemployment benefits. As you've indicated, unemployment is very high. A lot of people have no income. It, again, doesn't go as far as I would want, but I think we're talking about a supplement of $300 on top of regular unemployment. I think it's now for 13 weeks. And also, I should point out, Wolf, importantly, that I think President-elect Biden fully understands the nature of the crisis. As soon as his administration is in office, I think we can expect to see a significant step forward in addressing a lot of what was not dealt with in this bill. So this is, in a sense, a down payment. This is not the end of the discussion. The American people, working families, are hurting. We have got to respond. We're doing something now. We'll do more when Biden takes office.
When do you expect this vote to happen? It's got to happen within the next few days, but do you have a timeline?
I don't think anybody really knows that right now.
But you're going to stay in D.C. until this is done. You're not going back to Vermont.
I am not, and I don't think anybody can or should. We cannot go back to our families when so many families in this country are hurting right now. We've got to get this done.
I know we got to run, but let me ask you one final question while I have you, Senator. The president-elect Joe Biden has nominated your fellow former presidential candidate, Pete Buttigieg, who's a moderate Democrat, to serve as the new transportation secretary. You've called for more progressive voices to have leadership roles in the incoming Biden administration. Do you think the president-elect is doing enough right now to amplify progressive voices and policies?
As I've said many times, I don't. You know, the progressive movement in this country, and remember, I was the runner-up to Biden, and we got a few votes. Elizabeth Warren got a few votes. A number of progressives won seats to Congress. And those voices of millions and millions of people deserve representation in the Biden cabinet. And if you're asking me, have I seen that at this point? I haven't. I've seen some really good, very bright, very competent people, and I know many of them. They're good people, good selections. But if you're asking me, have we seen the kind of progressive appointments, nominations that I would like to see, the answer is not yet.
That was precisely what I was asking you, and you gave me a straight answer. Senator Sanders, as usual, thank you so much for joining us. Good luck with this legislation. The country needs it. Millions of people are suffering right now. They need help. And Congress needs to act. Appreciate it very much.
Thank you.